Being a doctor isn't always easy. Long hours, high-stress environments, and high volumes of patients with increasing demands, all while juggling these during a pandemic. So, I thought to myself, what would be the one thing that would make our lives as a doctor better? If I had the Infinity Gauntlet like Thanos, and could change one thing with a click of my fingers, what would it be? Naturally, being a doctor, I thought the best way to find this out would be to conduct an experiment. So let's find out the results. Alright, so it's not actually an experiment that involves beakers or pipettes. It's actually a qualitative, retrospective study on the optimum working conditions of doctors working in the NHS. Basically, I made a poll on Reddit. But the findings were very interesting. So from over 1,000 votes, here are the top 6 requests by doctors to make their lives better. Coming up as the least important was a doctor's mess room. This is basically a room where we used to be able to come and relax in the hospital. If you're lucky, there might be a TV, a fridge, some food. It's basically somewhere where you can go to have your lunch or take a break when you're on call. But the powers that be have mostly decided that doctors don't need breaks, so why would you even need a mess room? Either way, it seems that most people don't rank this as that important anyway, so it comes in last place. In 5th place is functioning printers. Honestly, this was actually my first choice. I mean, with all of the advances in modern technology, it is truly astounding how terrible printers still are. They never do what they're told, and they're always jammed or running out of toner. Can Apple or someone please target this?
Safety regulations at the peak!
And in 4th place is somewhere to sleep on night shifts. This surprised me, as I thought this would actually be more important. But I guess people weren't that fussed about it, because either some doctors simply don't get the chance to sleep on a night shift, I'm looking at you medics and pediatrics, or that their hospital already has somewhere to sleep. Moving swiftly on, in 3rd place we have computers that don't run Windows XP. Yep, you heard that right.
Today we're going to be talking about PowerPoint. PowerPoint.
At least 17% of doctors are in NHS hospitals that still have Windows XP, which is definitely not supported by updates anymore, and is definitely a gaping hole in the security of patient records. The last trust I'd worked at luckily had it upgraded to Windows 7. Yep, still 3 operating systems out of date. And if anyone thought the NHS is at the cutting edge of technology, think again. In 2nd place, with over 1/4 of votes, it was free car parking. Now, it might not seem like a big deal, but it's just something so easy to fix. Most doctors don't live near the hospitals they work at, because every year they're rotated to somewhere new, and that means most people can easily commute at least an hour to work. And simple things like free car parking would just take away one little source of stress. What's even worse is that some hospitals don't even have parking at all. So if you're not in work by 8 a.m. in the morning, you simply don't get a spot, and probably end up with a ticket for parking somewhere you're not meant to. Ugh.
They took away my parking space, but they can't take away my pride.
And finally, the number one request by doctors is to actually be paid their salary on time. And bear in mind, we're not asking for a raise, we're not asking to be paid any more than we are. We're literally just asking to be paid the amount that's in our contract each month on time. And you'd be shocked to know how many people simply don't get paid the right amount.
I declare bankruptcy!
Now, these are doctors who still have postgraduate training, with plenty of student debt already and 0 savings. Just like anyone else, they have rent and mortgages and dependents to look after as well. So not being paid for a few months, or for some crazy reason only being paid half their salary, can be seriously damaging. And if you thought your HR department wasn't great, trust me, any NHS trust would give them a run for their money, if they could actually calculate the money properly. And that concludes this week's experiment. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you want to find out what's scaring doctors right now, watch this video. If you've ever wondered if artificial intelligence could eliminate the need for doctors altogether, watch this video. And I guess I'll see you next time. See ya.